Hi, this is Richard Byrne at freetechforteachers.com. In this video, we're going to take a look at how you can use handwriting in Google Documents through the use of GMath. Now, GMath earlier this week was enabled for forms for using handwriting, and now you can use the same thing in Google Documents. And before we go any further, I have to give a big shout out to John Stevens, who alerted me to this both times this week. And if you're the type of person who prefers screenshots and written directions, I'd encourage you to check out John's site at fishingfortech.com to see the written directions on this. I'm going to give you a little screencast of it here. So here's my document, and you see I've just got a sample document up here. Let me go to Add-ons, and I have GMath already installed. If you don't have GMath already installed, simply go to Get Add-ons and do a search for GMath, just like you see it spelled here. And then you can go ahead and instead of a manage button, you'll see the free button. Click the free button and allow the permissions and you're good to go. So I already have it added. There's GMath. Let's say create a handwriting entry. And now we have the option over here to just use my mouse and write. You don't have to be a great writer, and it's a little bit tricky writing with a mouse. If I want to do 4 + 4 = 8, it's a little bit tricky for me. Some of you may be better at it than I am. If you have a touchscreen computer, of course, it'll be much, much easier. And so I've got my little entry here. Let's go ahead now and insert that into the document. And we see now it's appeared in the document. It's going to appear wherever you've left off your cursor. So if you need to move it around, you can click and drag the corners. If you want to wrap text or break text, you can do that, or inline text, you can move it around to align to the rest of the text on the page if you need to. So again, that's GMath for Google Documents. It's a free add-on and it enables handwriting of your math entries into Google Documents. And for more tips and tricks like this, check out freetechforteachers.com.